Hey, hello everyone. So in this video I'm going to show you how to construct a use case diagram for online railway reservation or online ticket reservation system. So let's get started. So I've already done use case diagrams for online shopping system and online library management system. So if you also want that, you can check that in the videos. And before going to this video, do subscribe my channel. It's absolutely free and it takes no time. And thanks for doing that. So let's get started. So currently I have staruml. So after opening that, you need to go to model and add diagram and just select use case diagram. So necessary objects for considered use case diagram will be displayed. So we are here, we are going to have like two actors. One actor is going to be, as you know, the passenger or the customer who is going to book the ticket, and another one is going to be like it can be like agent, okay, intermediate agent who is like controlling all this ticket booking, or it can directly be the railway system itself, okay, like it can be automated one or a person can like manage those. So it can be anything. So let's get started. So first just click the actor and paste it. So this one is going to be the passenger. And this one is going to be the, I think, railway agent or the system. Okay, that's good. So in case of dependencies, like we need to have like all sorts of loans. So like for example, let's begin with the register. Okay, so this register is like common, only exclusive for the passenger, because if any new passenger comes in, like he or she is first going to register and then login. But this register isn't available for the railway agent, because he's like the, he has the control over the entire system. So he can't be like new. He's going to be like pre-registered, and he's pre-registered, as I told you earlier. So he has like control before anyone. So this register is exclusive for passenger, and you need to also have like exclusive for the railway agent as well as the passenger, and you need to also have like common for both of them. So that's how it makes sense. Like you need to be like a valid one. So next one is going to be login. Okay, login. So this one is common for, as I told you, common for both the passenger and the railway agent. And the next use case is going to be like search for train. Okay, so this one is exclusive for the passenger, and next one is going to be like book ticket. Okay, book ticket. So this one is also like exclusive for the passenger. And like next one is also like exclusive. I will just drag and drop. And update details. Okay, so this is like used by the user when he or she wants to change like any details regarding personal info, address, like that. So this can be like update details. And next one is the payment. Okay, fare payment. Okay, so these are all like things that are exclusive for the passenger. So now we are going to do some stuff like exclusive for the railway agent or the system. So for the railway agent, I think the most important thing is like refund. Okay, refund. So this is like a really important thing, because refund of payment. Okay, so in case of like any train cancellation of any trains, or like any because of some natural disaster like rain, flood, like that, the train has to be cancelled. So at that case, like if the passengers have booked tickets, and it's a duty of the railway agent or the system to refund the money. So I think this is one of the most important things there, and it's like a perfect example for exclusive use case exclusive for the railway agent or the system. So refund payment. And another one is going to be like offer notifications. So in case of like offer or new train notifications, so as a whole it can be named like just plain notification, but I'm naming it as offer notifications. Okay, so this one is like in case of any new special trains for festivals, or there is some discount in case of any festivals, this can be like notified by the railway agent or system to the passengers. So that is also like exclusive for the agent. Another one for passenger is like cancel ticket. Okay, so after booking, like the passenger can even cancel the ticket. Cancel ticket. So it's going to be book tickets and cancel the tickets. Okay, so that is good. And another use case is going to be like check status. Okay, and in some cases like the ticket may be full and we have pre-booked and we need to wait for others to cancel. So can like check the status also for the ticket, whether it has been booked successfully or it is in the waiting list also. So it can be like check status is good. And in case of like a passenger, there are like many stuff, other stuff also. You can like ticket history can be added and payment history can be added like that. And train location can also be added. Like there are many apps and system that even shows at what station or what place the train is currently in, like that can be added. And another thing that can be also added exclusive for railway agent or system is the statistics. Okay, statistics of tickets. Okay, so this is like exclusively available for only for the railway agent or railway agency who is handling it. So this includes like how many passengers are traveling per day, total amount gained and total expenses for the railway system and the trains availability, ticket availability count, like all, it covers all the profit loss, etc. So that's also going to be stored and it's going to be exclusive one for our railway agent. Okay, so I'll just arrange it. So I think this many are good. Okay, this is more than enough, I guess. I added like really many, so I'll just put the arrows. Okay, so passenger registers. Okay, and another arrow, then after registration is going to be login and it's going to search for trains. Like it's really easy. Like you can get more use cases like if you go in order. Like just imagine you are going to the system and you're just booking a ticket and what are the steps you will follow. Like when you, by doing that way, you can just get more number of use cases. Otherwise it's going to be difficult. Like you need to like imagine yourself doing that particular stuff. Okay, that's good. And passenger is going to book ticket. Cancel. Update the details. Check status. Fare payment. Okay, that's good. And others are like exclusive for login is common. Okay. As I told you, you can also add register for railway agent, but I think like they are the one who controls it. Like they need to be like pre-registered itself. So I don't think there's a point of giving register for the railway agent. And refund is going to be for our railway agent, as I told you, our system. So, and offer notifications and statistics of the tickets. So I think this is like really good. It's looking like shabby. I have not given enough space in between. So I hope these are like some of the important ones. You can also add like check for availability of tickets, choose the particular seat, okay, that you will have in the side, in the center also, you can add that also. So you can also add your like details, okay. So I have added details, I guess. So I think this is more than enough I have done. Most important things are like book tickets, cancel, fare payment and refund. That's this for 4 and 5 are like important, and others are like common for all the online systems. So hope this you have found useful this video, and mine is a program channel. I have done tutorials in C++, Python, Java, Blender 3D animation and Unity. So do check other videos of my channel. I also done use case diagrams, activity diagrams, class diagrams in staruml. You can also check that and subscribe and support me, and thanks for watching.